guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Sihle, and on this channel we talk about everything books, self-help, personal development, and everything in line with that. So in today's video we have the beautiful Yenzi right here. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe. All right, please introduce yourself.
Okay, hi guys, my name is Yenzi. I also have a channel talking mainly about intentional living, figuring it out in your 20s, and just life pretty much.
So guys, I've prepared like a number of questions over here to ask Yenzi, because, well, she's, for one, she's a very interesting woman, so you better follow her on her socials. You better follow her on her socials. She shares very insightful content, and especially if you're a young millennial who's trying to grow in a space of content creation and digital entrepreneurship and everything in line with that. So I'd really advise you guys to actually hop onto her channel and be great. Alright, just like for you to actually share a bit of insights about yourself and what you do.
Cool.
So the first question I prepared for you is, what do you do and how long have you been doing it?
I would say that I'm a person who's really trying to break into the marketing space. I'm passionate about that. I realize that I'm really, really passionate about people, specifically African people, serving African people. I know that's my vibe, that's my stuff. So currently I'm trying to get through that nonsense called my degree.
I can relate.
So that I can break into the marketing space specifically. So I do all things related to social media. I'm specifically focusing on creating content for LinkedIn, YouTube, and Instagram. Those are like platforms that I feel like I could really, really expand and really get to talk about what I'm passionate about on. So that's pretty much me. Yeah.
All right. And do you mind telling us about what you're studying, your degree,
I'm doing BCom accounting, but I realized, you would see, it's not gonna be me for a very long time. I'm not into financial services. I'm into communications and specifically marketing, all things marketing. So that's why everything I do, I wanted to kind of be on my profile in terms of, this is what I've done, this is how I've been able to not only build maybe my brand but also any other business that I'm related or rather working on. So for example, I manage social media for two people actually, Student Movers and The Business Back Home. So everything that I kind of touch, I wanted to go back to my profile in terms of building a marketing career.
Okay, and then so what are the challenges you faced in terms of getting clients, working with clients?
Well, one of the things in terms of social media especially, like one of the things that I think is a problem is explaining to people how much you need a digital presence. For example, like I'm from a very rural area. People don't understand why you even need a website, you know? They just don't prioritize that. So that's been a struggle. And also, look, I'm a person, I got into marketing because I can take someone's vision and I can be like, that's how you related to Generation Z, people my age. So you can do this, 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 and that. And I'm a person who, like, I really want to grow into becoming a person who can really, really take your brand and take it to the next level. But people, I think we're still very much struggling with investing money into
that
digital.
Yes,
like,
yes, that's
true. It's not a thing,
that's,
you know?
True.
And I get it, like, I get it, marketing for people who are old is talking. That's the fundamental.
Word of mouth most of the time, and it's just, yeah.
That's true. How they know how to get their business. But nowadays, you can even take it a notch further and go online and really, really be accessible online.
But also, I feel like it's very tricky because I think that's also why we need social media managers like yourself, because sometimes you can have presence on social media, but because it's such a big space, it's very easy to also fumble.
Yeah.
So if you don't necessarily know how to manage your profile and just your being holistically on social media, you could actually do things that are not in alignment with your brand, or maybe just things that could throw you off. It's more difficult to create a profile online or build your brand online, and it's very easy to actually fumble it. How do you then like teach people how to continue to actually run their brands? Because if you're working with specific individuals, I feel like there is going to get to a time where you're like, okay, I'm handing it over back to you. So how do you then ensure that people still maintain the same standard or the same profile that you've actually built for them?
I think, you know, Adne, the fundamental thing has been communication for me. For example, right, when I started with Student Movers, which is this year, by the way, like, I started being aware of what I want to do in terms of what I'm doing for myself and my career. So when I started with them, like, the first thing that I think with anyone, right, you have to communicate, right? You have to, like, both of you guys know that, listen, this is where we're trying to get as a business. For me, that's been the biggest thing. Like, I think in any setting, right, even if you're a team, if you guys don't know your bigger vision, then there's gonna be that one person, right? And also, I think even if you're working independently as a freelancer in social media management, for anyone who wants to get into that, I think you just really need to believe in what the person that you're working for or working with, you need to believe in what they're doing. Like, so back home, right, I have a community project called Bring Something Back, something that I started like in 2017. And that's when I actually learned this thing of being one in a team. When one person doesn't understand,
don't leave them behind.
And it just influences the bigger mission. Because, for example, in a community, right? So we're small. I come from a very small community. And if one person doesn't get what we're doing and they spread the wrong message,
It affects everyone.
So I'd say communication. That's my biggest thing.
On to the next question. How do you deal with pressure? And what advice would you have for someone in their 20s who feels like they're not doing anything in their life, or even when they are, but you sometimes, especially social media again, you could be doing something with your life and then you get online and you start maybe comparing yourself to your friends or start projecting other people's successes as your failures, you know.
Mina, I think in our 20s, self-awareness is like the best thing you could ever do for yourself. Like, it takes you from this level to another level. First things first, you have to realize what are these things, why are they triggering me like this, right? And then you have to consistently be aware of the fact that when you're a person who's triggered by someone else buying a Mini Cooper, yes, it's your dream car, and then you see it on someone else, yo. So I think
there's actually, I don't know, I did speak about this book on my channel, it's called Girl Code. When you're mentioning those points, she highlights that also, self-awareness. When you self-aware, you actually start to realize the things that make you tick. Like the example you just gave, someone buys a Mini Cooper and because it's your dream car, you feel some type of way. So she was saying that pay attention to those things. Pay attention to those feelings.
Like, pay attention to your negative feelings.
Yeah, like where are you triggered? So, because it can't be... Personally, I wouldn't feel some type of way when someone probably becomes a comedian, because it's not my inspiration. So she's like, pay attention to those feelings, with what actually is your trigger, and start working from there. Start learning how to move from envy to inspiration. And I think it changed a lot for me, like having that knowledge of, okay, so Yenzi has started her career as an entrepreneur, and it is something that I would like to do. So instead of me hating on Nintendo, I would rather move from that envy and actually come to you and be like, yo dude, I really really admire what you're doing, and what is it that I need to do to get to where you are. People have projected this thing that women like to compete with each other, but I've seen a lot of them look at us, here we
it's
are
not,
collaborating,
it's really not,
you know what I mean.
And I think us, like our generation, we're moving on out of that mountain, way past I think also about recognizing negative feelings, also recognize positive feelings, also recognize your milestones. Guys, we don't celebrate our milestones. Like Tina,
we want them to be big.
You got a channel, you've done 100 subscribers, you move past that like nobody's business. All because it's like, it's just happening, and you thought it would be like, oh my goodness, this amazing thing. But it is this amazing thing.
It is,
thing.
It really is.
And you just literally didn't take the time to celebrate
and
it.
And take it in.
Like, if you don't acknowledge it, and like for me, right, people keep on acknowledging that, yo dude, you're doing amazing. But if you don't acknowledge it, it'll just be such a ridiculous thing, but it's literally not.
And I think also you don't even have to wait for people to acknowledge it. I think you're also robbing yourself of a lot of happiness when you wait for people outside to validate you. I've gotten to a point where I clap for myself for getting a good mark in a practical, you know, like I feel like that's a milestone, because it's gonna accumulate into me actually doing well for that module entirely, as opposed to me just looking at the end goal, which is to pass the module. Because essentially, to pass that specific module, you have to build on something, which is those assessments that you do in between. So I also feel like you don't need to wait for people to actually validate you, that, oh, you're doing great, for you to acknowledge it.
Yeah, and also just understanding that, man, the age-old principle, people don't acknowledge how much your time and your journey literally has a different texture, has a different way compared to everyone else's. It doesn't work the same. Things don't work the same.
On pace, on race. I just want to ask, what's your take on reading books outside academic contents if you are in the academic space?
So, okay, we're going to speak about this on the video, né? But like, books, I remember in primary, books changed me. Like, my favorite book ever is The Host, né? And it's like, absolutely not my type. It's science fiction, and I'm not into that. But that book taught me about prejudice at a very young age, by the way. So I saw it and I was like, oh, okay, no, I don't want to ever be that person. With everyone that ever interacts with me, they need to know that they're safe at a very young age. So I know that books literally can change your life. Like, you literally get to hear from someone else's brain. And the other thing with books, I think when you're reading, right, I personally like a hard copy. When you're reading, right, you get to think very slowly.
I like hard copy, but isn't it expensive? I feel like hard copy.
I know. And for a digital person, I should be the one who's like, no guys, buy Audible, do this, do that. But I'm still old fashioned, like, when it comes
to books. Also really enjoy hard copy, but the expensive, well, for me, I feel like the expensive to buy, especially if I'm buying
for me as well. Like, what do you mean? I also
we don't know that.
Nah, they are.
Like, also, I feel like books are an investment.
Yeah, né?
And it's not an investment that will have, like, the ROI on, well, returns on investment on for reading books isn't something that's probably tangible. So I'm assuming that's why people aren't, like, looking at it as an investment. But I feel like they do change person that you are.
They do. Like,
so yes, back to you.
Imagine hearing from a CEO, hearing how they built their lives. Like, a book that I want to read is Shoe Dog, from the person who founded Nike.
Okay.
Imagine hearing about the start till the end to what it is now. That's one of the greatest brands in the world, and you get to hear firsthand every night or whatever time you read how he did that. That's what books mean to me, and I committed to reading more this year.
You should. Okay, so guys, we've come to the end of today's video. I hope you guys really liked it. If you have any questions for Yanzi, please leave them in the comments down below. Any topic suggestions that we should speak about in our next collaboration if it is happening. So thank you guys so much and say your goodbyes.
Thank you for having me over. Thank you for watching till the end. I hope you found this insightful. Anyway, on YouTube. Anyway, actually, my name is Y-E-N-Z-I. Yenzi, that's how you spell it.